Hello, I am Benjamin Pock. I'm the principal of Peridot, Our Savior's Lutheran School. 2020, huh? I think you guys know how much our lives have been changed by this pesky virus here, and welcoming you to our Christmas service for 2020. With everything else looking different, well, this Christmas service is going to look different too. Your lives have looked a lot different this past year. Unfortunately, some of us have indeed lost loved ones. And all of us, in one way or another, have been affected by this coronavirus. Whether it's eating behind plexiglass, or whether it's having to shout to your neighbor, or whether it's really truly wondering where in the world you're going to get toilet paper from, this coronavirus has really changed a lot of things. And I think what can be worse is that because of COVID, we just have so many questions. And so many questions are out there that just don't seem to have answers. And in fact, when we do finally get an answer, the answers we do get seem to raise 20 more questions. Now we have a vaccine, but are we closer to school? I think probably yes, but to put a specific date and give an exact answer, we just don't have that. You might be wondering, where's the joy nowadays? Where can we find our joy? We have fleeting joy. Maybe our team wins the game. You look around, and this year you probably had Grandma, if you're wondering if she can still do cartwheels, when Grandma and Mommy and Daddy are more excited for Christmas break than students. That's some excitement there. You might even know what may be waiting for you under the tree. That's exciting, but that's fleeting. That doesn't last forever. But today we have good news. As Christians, we have eternal joy. We have the answers right here in the manger of Christ, to know that Christ loves us so much, He came down on this earth to live for us. And not only live perfectly for us, but to die on the cross willingly to wash away our sins and to rise and conquer death. We do have joy. And we have eternal joy. We have the answer right here in Jesus Christ. And that's what our children, that's what our students are going to be telling us in this Christmas service here in 2020. And that's what we're going to teach the children every day. Every day at Peridot-Our Savior's Lutheran School is we have eternal joy in Jesus. So I want to welcome you to our Christmas service in 2020. It's entitled Silent Night, Holy Night, Vision Bright.
Hello. I'm Mr. Chris Bonstock. I'm the assistant principal and the 7th and 8th grade teacher here at Peridot Mission School. I've been serving here for 6 years. As is tradition, our 8th graders have been working really hard to learn and memorize their portion of the gospel message, which is the fulfillment of all the promises of Messiah in the form of Jesus Christ, our Savior. They are going to be reading from Luke chapter 2, and listen closely as they tell how all of those promises were fulfilled in the form of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Hello, I'm Pastor Tim. I serve as pastor down there at Peridot Mission and here at Grace Lutheran Church in San Carlos. I'm glad that you are able to join us for this virtual Christmas service. I pray that God will bless you through the good news that a Savior has been born to us. Let's join in our opening prayer. Lord Jesus, you are the true light of the world. Thank you for coming into the world to bring joy and peace to all. Give us that peace. I pray for everyone who watches this Christmas service, for those who are already your people. Let your light shine brightly in their lives as they share your good news. For those who are coming to know you for the first time, or coming to know you after a long time away, I pray that you will light the fire of your love within their hearts. May we all sing with the angels and join with your holy people everywhere to say, joy to the world, the Lord is come. Amen.
Hello, and Merry Christmas. My name is Mr. Luke Ziemer. I serve here at Peridot Our Savior's Lutheran School as the fourth grade teacher and athletic director. I'd ask that you join my class in singing our first hymn, Hark the Glad Sound. This hymn was written by Pastor Philip Doddridge from Northampton, England. It was published for common use in 1755. Shortly after, Pastor Doddridge passed away from tuberculosis, which was a worldwide pandemic at that time, and is considered the world's oldest pandemic. I'd ask that now you sing with my fourth grade class, Hark the Glad Sound.
The glad sound, the Savior comes, the Savior promised long. Let every heart prepare a throne, and every voice a song. He comes the captives to release, in Satan's prison bell. The gates of brass before him burst, the iron fetters yield. He comes the broken heart to bind, the bleeding soul to of his grace to enrich the humble poor. Our glad hosannas, Prince of Peace, your welcome shall proceed, and heaven's eternal arches ring with your beloved name.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register.
Merry Christmas and God's blessings to you and your family. I'm Mr. Zarnstorff. I teach the sixth grade at Peridot Our Savior's Lutheran School. This is my first year here in Peridot. After coming down from Anchorage, Alaska, where I served Faith Lutheran Church and school for many years. This next hymn is one that we used to use quite often to open our Christmas services in Anchorage. The children would lead a candlelight procession into the church singing this song. Once in Royal David City was a poem written by Cecil Francis Alexander in 1848. The music was added about a year later by an organist, John Henry Gauntlet. The words of the hymn highlight our Savior's birth and his purpose for coming to earth, namely to redeem us and to give us a forever home with him in heaven. Please join your voices with the sixth graders in the praise of our Savior.
City stood alone, the cattle shed, where a mother laid her baby in a manger for his bed. Mary was that mother mild, Jesus Christ, her little child. Came down to earth from heaven, who is God and Lord of all, and his shelter was a stable, and his cradle was a stall. With the poor and mean and lowly lived on earth our Savior.
shall see him through his own redeeming love. For that child, so dear and gentle, is our Lord in heaven above. And he leads his children.
Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he was next in line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child.
Philip Brooks authored our next Christmas hymn. He served as rector of the Church of the Advent, Philadelphia, and Trinity Church in Boston. His carol, O Little Town of Bethlehem, was written for his Sunday school in 1868, after he had spent Christmas 2 years earlier in Bethlehem. The hymn brings out our hopes and fears that are met and defeated by the birth of our promised Savior, Jesus Christ. Please join in singing with the seventh graders.
O little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark streets shineth the God imparts to human hearts the blessings of his heaven. No ear may hear his coming, but in this world of sin, where meek souls will receive him still, the dear Christ enters in. Yeah.
There, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son, wrapped him in cloth, and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room.
Hello, I am Mrs. Chapman. This is my 7th year teaching at Peridot-Our Saviors. Our kindergartners have prepared one of the most famous Christmas carols, Away in a Manger. This hymn is often attributed as being written by Martin Luther in the late 1800s, due to it first being published in 1885 in a book called The Lutheran Sunday School Book, under the title Luther's Cradle Hymn. Please join my students in singing the story of Christ's birth. The third verse is a wonderful prayer to learn for every evening all year long.
Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the bright sky look down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. The cattle are lowing, the baby awakes, but little Lord Jesus no crying he makes. I love you, Lord Jesus, look down from the sky and stay by my side until morning is nigh. Be near me, Lord Jesus, I ask you to stay close by me forever. Love me, I pray. Bless all the dear children in your tender care, and take us to heaven to live with you there.
And there were shepherds living out in the field nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
Hi, I'm Mr. Ivan. I'm the 5th grade teacher in my 5th year of teaching at Peridot-Our Savior's School. My class is going to be sharing with you the song called Where Shepherds Lately Knelt. It was written about 100 years ago by a man named Yaroslav Vajda, and it traces the path of the Old Testament believers and how they were anxiously waiting for the Christ child, the Messiah, to come and save them, and how those shepherds were so excited on that very first Christmas day to rush out and see the Christ child, their Savior, their Messiah, laying in a manger, and how we also look back at that event with that same excitement, with the same awe and wonder that God sent his one and only Son to save us, and how he was born in Bethlehem on that very first Christmas day. God bless you as you worship with us.
Where shepherds lately knelt and kept the angel's word, I come in half belief, a pilgrim strangely stirred. But there is room and welcome there for me. But there is room and welcome there for me. In that
unlikely place I find him, as they said. Sweet newborn babe, how frail and in a manger bed. A still small voice to cry one day for me. A still small voice to cry one day. His prophecies fulfilled, with pounding heart I stare. A child, a son, a prince of peace for me. A child, a son, a prince of peace for me. Can I, will I forget how love was born and burned?
But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I give you good news of great joy that will be for all people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
Hello, my name is Mrs. Dietrich. I teach first graders at Peridot-Our Savior Lutheran School. This is my fourth year teaching there. The first 2 years were art and music, and these last years have been with the first graders. We have prepared for you, He is Born, the Divine Christ Child, a Christmas carol written in the 1800s. We don't know who the author is of this carol, but it was first written and sung in French. Nowadays, you can find it in Christian hymnals that are printed in English and Korean. So this is a very famous Christmas carol. It is a fulfillment of the Old Testament prophecy that Christ would be born of a woman and under the law. And that is fulfilled in Galatians 4:4. But when the time had fully come, God sent forth His Son, born of a woman, born under the law. Please join us in singing, He is Born, the Divine Christ Child.
Yeah. Suddenly a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests."
This is Benjamin Poggle again, and serving in my 11th year here at the Peridot Our Savior's Lutheran Mission School. Besides being principal, I also co-teach third grade. I want to welcome you to join our very talented, wonderful third graders in the next Christmas hymn, which Mrs. Rautenberg is going to explain a little bit further.
Hello, my name is Mrs. Rautenberg. I'm in my 5th year of teaching third grade here at Peridot Our Savior Lutheran School. Our third grade carol this year is Angels We Have Heard on High. It was translated from French to English in 1843. It's probably most famous for the Gloria in Excelsis Deo refrain, where the O in Gloria is sustained through 18 notes of rising and falling melody. As the third graders can probably tell you, the refrain is Latin and means Glory to God in the Highest. Join us as we sing the story of the shepherds who saw a great multitude of angels praising God for the birth of our Savior.
Angels we have heard on high,
sweetly singing o'er the blood,
and the mountains in reply,
echoing their joyous strife.
Treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Merry Christmas. I am Mrs. Zarnsdorf, teacher of the second grade students at Peridot Our Saviors. The Christmas hymn we present to you is the African-American spiritual, Go Tell It on the Mountain. The message is clear. Tell people about Jesus. Share your faith in Christ. Shine in witnessing to others. Sing of your Savior. Talk about what happened in Bethlehem and what Jesus Christ has done for you. Sing it loudly and from your heart like a second grade student.
Pastor Joseph Dietrich. I serve at Our Savior's Lutheran in Bilas, and we thank God for this wonderful Christmas service, and we pray. Lord God, we thank you for again reminding us of your eternal love for all people as we once again remember the birth of your Son. Lord, by ourselves, we are filled with sin of every kind. Without your forgiveness and the love of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, born in Bethlehem, we would have no hope in life or in death. Without Jesus, we would be condemned to hell. Tonight we rejoice in the good news that a Savior has been born for all people. We further rejoice that he grew up and completed all he needed to do to take away the sins of the world. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. We thank and praise you, Lord, for such a Savior. We also thank you for the privilege of sharing your word in our world. We thank you for the joy of sharing your forgiveness with all our students and families. We pray that you watch over and keep all of our students and families in your loving care. Forgive their sins, strengthen them, and help them in all their needs. Bless them as they share your word. We thank you for our teachers and leaders of the school. Bless them and strengthen them in this important work. You've told us to proclaim your name as faithful servants. Help us always to bring glory to your name. Heavenly Father, we also ask that you would allow us to return to school in person so that we might encourage one another and help those who are struggling. According to your will, take away the strength of this virus and allow us to gather again together in school and church to praise your holy name. Lord, we bring this and all other petitions to you in the name of Jesus, our Savior, in whose name we pray. Amen.
Hi, my name is Pastor Dan Rautenberg. I've been living and serving on an Apache reservation now for almost 20 years as a pastor, as the director of the Apache Christian Training School, and for the last 4 years serving as the field coordinator living here in Peridot. I realize that this hasn't been the same year or the same Christmas as most of my experiences on the reservation. I remember some of our wonderful experiences listening to Broadest Bones or Bonnie Lewis, reading the Christmas story in the Apache language while the choir hummed Silent Night in a candlelight service. I remember those candy bags that they used to hand out with an orange and an apple and that special kind of hard candy that you only get at Christmas time. I had a lot of good memories of those Christmas services, and this year is a little bit different. But when you think about it, what's most important at Christmas is exactly the same thing. Those were good memories of the way that the Christmas service was held, but the most important thing about Christmas is Jesus. He's the star of Christmas. He is the reason that we celebrate. It's an extraordinary story. There's none like it in all the world, how God would actually leave heaven and come here. He would make himself poor. He would make himself helpless, vulnerable. He would do it all to save us, to live and to die, to take away our sins, and give us a place in heaven in his kingdom. There is no other story like it in the world. It's the best story in all the world, and that's the reason why we celebrate. It's also the heart of what we do as Native Christians. And a couple wonderful things that have been happening this year in spite of that pandemic. We want to thank Mrs. Kashina Miles for redoing our Native Christians website at www.nativechristians.org. And she did a wonderful job. You should check it out and go there and see how the gospel can be proclaimed to people digitally. We also hope to put our entire Christian training program there. The Apache Christian Training School can also be delivered online. somebody can get the Bible training, the solid Bible training that we offer, no matter where they live or what other job they may be holding at the time. That's going to be a wonderful opportunity for us. And finally, we've also had a number of good conversations with a lot of Native folks in Farmington, New Mexico. They've asked us to assist them in spreading the gospel in their part of the world. And what a wonderful thing it is for us to have Native Christians serving as missionaries. That's the heart and soul of Native Christians. And it's the heart and soul of who we are and who Christ has made us to be. To share that wonderful, wonderful, extraordinary news about Jesus with more and more people, that the rooms of heaven may be filled. That's what Christmas is about. That's what Native Christians is about. And that's what I hope is also the heart of your joy at this time of year. Now I'd like you to join with the pastors and the teachers and the staff of the San Carlos Reservation and join us in singing a song that talks about that extraordinary Jesus with great joy. Joy to the World is the song that we're going to sing. It was based on Psalm 98, where the writer of that psalm talks about how heaven and earth, all of nature, all of creation sings for joy because Jesus, who came at Christmas, will come again and we will be with him forever. Wonderful news, great tidings, great joy. Sing together with us.
Curses found.